What's up, everyone? I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'll show you how to create a heat map for your data in Google Sheets. Getting all of your data organized in a Google Sheets document is a great first step to take command of your information. However, even at that point, large data sets can still be overwhelming and difficult to really understand. One way to get a deeper understanding of your data is to apply a heat map to it. Applying a heat map in Google Sheets gives you a clean visual representation of the highs, lows, and all of the layers in between for specific data elements. Thankfully, creating a heat map in Google Sheets is easy and can be done with a few quick clicks. Now let's walk through the steps to create a heat map for your data in Google Sheets. Step 1. Open a web browser, navigate to www.sheets.google.com, and then open the Google Sheet with the dataset you want to lay a heat map over. In this example, I've got a dataset showing Tom Brady's career passing stats. Step 2. Highlight the data you want to apply a heat map to. In this example, I'll highlight my column that shows passing yards. Step 3. Click Format in the menu across the top of the screen to open a drop-down menu, and then click Conditional Formatting in that menu. A Conditional Format Rules window opens on the screen. Step 4. Click Color Scale in this window. The color scale options are now shown in this window, and you'll see the current color scale logic applied to your chosen dataset in your Google Sheets sheet. Step 5. In the Apply to Range section, verify the cell range that contains the data you want to apply a heat map to. Next, navigate to the Format Rules section. You can click the preview of your color scale to see other color scale options, or even create your own. You can scroll down in this window to set a minimum, mid, and maximum value and change the colors associated with those values. You'll see any changes you make in this section applied to your dataset automatically. Click Done when you're finished setting your conditional formatting heat map rules. The conditional formatting window will close. You can repeat this process to apply separate heat maps to different data elements within your larger data set. Let me know if this video helped you out in the comments below. If you liked what you saw here, click the video links on the right side of the screen to check out another video, or click the logo on the left side of the screen to check out my tutorial website at www.maxdalton.how.